Hey there, it's me again. So in the previous video, I walked you through history and you learned about matriarchal societies, both ancient and modern. And you learned that there is one thing that all these societies have in common. The one thing which is so important and so precious is women's inner energy, inner power, spiritual power, right? So, welcome to The Princess Left the Tower. I am Marilda, and today I'm going to share with you 7 tips on how to recover with this inner power that you have inside and how to use it. The 7 tips are inspired by Vicky Noble, who is the author of a wonderful book, which is The Double Goddess, Women Sharing Power. Tip number 1, respect your body and yourself. There is a connection between soul and body. These two elements communicate. But if you pollute your body with chemicals or junk food, and if you pollute your mind with negative thinking, limiting beliefs, or even distorted images of women, then this connection will be lost. And you will have the feeling of being trapped in a physical cage, which is our body, completely disconnected from the soul. So, first step is to take care of your body, nourish your body, respect your body. A healthy body is beautiful at all ages. So start from that. Tip number 2. Challenges are the transformative path to rebirth. I'm not reading a crystal ball, okay? I'm using this, but this may be the PCs, the more than crystal balls for modern witches like me or like you, if you're still watching this. So, we are all exposed to difficulties. We face problems, issues, we go through difficult times, right? And the thing is that if you don't accept these difficulties as a change, and if you fight against them instead of working to find a solution, then you feel very depressed and hopeless and frustrated, right? So the secret is to let it go. When you accept a problem, you are accepting a change, and you can actively work for a solution. For instance, maybe you are losing your job, or you're losing a person that you love, or you're sick. Every problem is a change of your routine, and if you don't accept it, you are going to crash again a wall. So let it go and position yourself in that positive perspective from which you can see the problem as it is a change and find a solution. Tip number 3, the power flows through your hands. And that's true. When you do something that you really like with your hands, for instance, maybe you like sewing your own dress, or drawing a painting, or maybe decorate a cake, or writing a blog post, a song, whatever, you feel all inspired and excited, no? And it's like you are going beyond this physical world, and you are entering another world, an invisible world, rich in inspiration and motivation. That's exactly how the energy flows through your hands, and it soon spreads all in all your body and soul. So do it as much as you can. Do what you like to do with your hands. Use them, okay? Those are powerful tools, right? Tip number 4, free your sexuality from dogma. I showed you all the picture in the previous episode of these deities, ancient goddesses, and they are all abundant, prosperous, big breasts, you know, big vagina, and these are all symbols of sexuality. So those women, those goddesses, were free to live their sexualities as they wanted, right? Nowadays, unfortunately, women are often considered as sexual object. But if you can really know your sexuality and live it with freedom, then you are moving from the concept of sexual object to the concept of sexual subject. So I invite you to get free of stereotypes and God dogma and feel free really to experiment your body and to live it as you wish, right? Tip number 5, intuition and instinct. You are familiar with the concept of the sixth sense or whatever. So there is something that we have inside that sometimes whispers to our ear, especially when we face a problem and we need to take a decision. Sometimes it happens that maybe you need to choose between two options or find a solution to a problem, and something inside you says go this way, and then you start using a rational process of decision making. So you analyze data, pros and cons, and then you find out a solution. And you go that way, but after a while you realize that the first option was the correct one. The first decision was the correct one, for that is intuition. We always have this intuition inside us, but we have forgotten how to listen to it. And so you should really listen to your body, listen to your core, to your voice. And whenever you need to take a decision, wait a bit, listen, and try to understand what this voice is trying to tell you. Tip number 6, know the mystery of the menstrual cycle. Yes, don't be ashamed of your menstruation. That is something which is sacred. It is a deep connection with Mother Earth, with the nature, with the moon. It's something which is amazing. Women are powerful because they can give life. They can nourish life. So no need to be ashamed of it. Whenever you feel down, you feel blue, think that it's a natural hormone process. So don't hide it. It's not necessary. Sometimes I hear, especially in workplaces, okay, she's in a bad mood, she's in those days, which is humiliating. Yes, maybe we have kind of, you know, bad days or whatever, but we just need to listen to the body and just accept it. That's it. No need to be ashamed of that, right? Tip number 7, the last one, responsibility, awareness, and action. So, first step, we said, we start from the body and then we go all through this transformation process. And now we are aware of this inner power, this huge inner energy. And once we are aware of it, we have to be responsible of it and use it. Use it means that you have to bring it to the surface and enjoyed it. And the next step is action. Because when you are aware and responsible, then you have to take actions. You can start even today from your daily reality, you know, from daily routine. Take action. Promise me that you will do something today to listen to your inner voice, to this power, bring it to the surface, use it, because it's huge. That means you need to believe in your immense, massive power. Use it for yourself, for the people you love, the people around you, and for the society, because it is beneficial, is really amazing. So make sure you use it. Okay, so I think that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon in the next video. Bye!